गाइज, दिस इज़ के पी स्टाइल्स. वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल. एंड इफ़ यू आर अ न्यू फेस आउट हियर एंड यू आर लुकिंग मी फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, सो आई एम के पी स्टाइल्स एंड आई मेक ऑल वीडियोज रिलेटेड टू ब्यूटी, मेकअप, हेयर एंड एवरीथिंग बेसिकली ब्यूटी रिलेटेड. सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड. एंड टूडेज वीडियो इज गोइंग टू बी ऑन आई मेकअप. सो I am going to today teach you how to do eye makeup, because eye makeup is the only thing which makes your complete, you know, makeup different from other people in the room. Because you can have a good base, you can have a good lipstick, but eye matters the most. Like if you are having a good eye makeup, your makeup look amazing. So I am going to today teach you that how to do eye makeup, all about, you know, eye makeup brushes and eye parts basically, in which most of the people are confused. So without further ado, let's get started. And please do not forget to like, share and subscribe, and please hit the notification button right beside the subscribe so that you will get notified whenever I upload a new video. So let's get started. Basically, whenever you watch a makeup tutorial or somebody who's doing makeup and explaining their makeup as well, you do not understand that what parts are they talking about, like, you know, eyelids or crease or brow bone, lash line. Like, there are a number of things and you do get confused sometimes. Like when I started my makeup, I also used to get very confused about, you know, between all the parts that which part is known as what. So first thing I'm going to tell you the complete eye area and what are the different parts called. So the first thing which comes is eyelid. So eyelid is basically this area of your eye on which most of the people, like, obviously, you know, where you apply your basic eyeshadow. Okay, so this semicircle here, this complete area is your eyelid. So on eyelid you apply, you know, shimmery shades or matte shades or whatever you shades you want. Just above your eyelid comes your crease. So if you want to know where your crease is, what you need to do is take a brush or just use your finger. The thing right here, just above your eyelid, you can feel a bone and a hollow space right here. This thing is known as your crease. So basically, in the crease, what you need to do is you need to pack a light shade. You always, like, every time you are doing makeup, firstly you have to place your crease color, then you have to do your eyelid or all the parts. So always try to put light colors in your crease rather than placing dark colors. You may place, you know, dark colors in your crease, but only when you are going for a bright or, you know, like a very smoky eye look, and when you have to apply really popping bright colors on your eyelid, then you can go with some dark crease color. But otherwise, what you use is like light pink, light brown, mauve, like basically all the light colors you have to go in with the crease. So just above the crease here, like right below your brow, this thing is known as your brow bone, on which you apply highlighter. Basically, there are two parts in your eyes where you apply highlighter. The first is this brow bone. Like most of the people apply their highlighter right from here to the end of their brow. You do not have to do that. Just apply your highlighter on your brow bone. First part is this one where you apply your highlighter. The second one is this. The second part is this, which is known as tear duct. And you also call it the inner corners of your eye. So basically, we apply our highlighter here so that you know, our inner eyes look really popped up and big basically. And you apply your highlighter here so that your brow look really snatched. So we are done with crease, eyelids, brow bone and tear duct. Next thing which comes is the lash lines. The place where your lashes are there, that is called your lash line. And the upper one is known as, obviously, upper lash line, and the lower one is known as lower lash line. It's just the place where your lashes are there. Okay, and just inside your lash line comes your waterline, the place where you apply your kohl or kajal. Like most of the girls apply is kajal. So this place is known as your waterline, and the place where your lashes are, that is known as your lash line. Lower one is known as lower waterline, and the upper one is known as upper waterline. So basically these are all the parts of your eyes where you do your makeup, obviously eye makeup. So next we are going to talk about the brushes, like what kind of brushes to use and what not. So talking about the brushes, like I have seen a lot of people who are like new to makeup or do not basically know how to do their complete eye makeup. Either they use this sponge tip brush or this one, as you can see, this flat shader brush. They use these two brushes to do their whole eye makeup. Like they will just grab this brush, take some eyeshadow and apply on their complete eyelid, crease, and they leave it there. So these brushes are used in eye makeup, but not for your complete eye makeup. You just use them for some basic parts. So I would be telling you all the makeup brushes, like I'm having all my eye makeup brushes here, and I would be telling you which brush to use where. So first thing comes is our crease. So in the crease, what you need to do is you need to take a fluffy brush, a fluffy blending brush, so that you can take a particular amount of eyeshadow and blend it really nicely in your crease. So you can use some this kind of brushes. These are round and these are really fluffy. Either you can use this buffing brush or you can use this flat top brush. It's also fluffy, it's also, you know, like big, but it has a flat top. When you want to particularly, you know, focus on your crease and you want to blend it out with this brush. So as I have told you, you always apply a really light color on your crease. So I am going to go with this pink shade or this pink shade right here, and I would be packing it in my crease and really blending it out nicely. So I'm just going to take a little bit of this shade, always dust it off so that the, you know, excess product gets removed. Now what you have to do is just feel your crease and then start blending your eyeshadow. You should never apply too much force on your brush. You need to blend it with really light hand so that your eyeshadow looks really blended out and really nice. So once you are done applying your crease color really nicely and you have blended it out as well, next thing comes is your outer V. The outer V is this area of your eye where you basically apply a little bit darker shade than what you have applied in your crease. So for your outer V, you can take these kind of angular fluffy brushes. As you can see, it is angular but it is fluffy, or these kind of brushes. So basically you use angular brushes for your outer V. You can also use the crease brush, but these type of brushes really help you to, you know, particularly focus on your outer V, and then you can blend it out using your fluffy brush. For the outer V, I'm going to take a dark brown eyeshadow, and what you basically have to do is take your angular brush, take on some dark brown eyeshadow or whatever color you want, and simply just pat in your outer V like this. Like you need to, you know, make a shape first and then you have to blend it out. So after being done with your outer V and crease, the next thing comes is your lid color. And the most important thing, like ever you are placing a color in your crease or your outer V, just make sure that you always use a matte shade. Do not use shimmery shades on your crease or on your outer V, because it looks really, you know, like clumsy or bad. Always try to use a matte shade whenever you are going for your crease or outer V. On your lid, you can apply any color you want. Either you want a shimmer color, either you want any kind of matte or semi matte, whatever shade you want. So the next thing comes is your lid. So on your lid, you can apply, as I have said, any color which you want. It can be a shimmery shade, it can be any shade. You can also use a single shade on your eyelid, and you can also go for, you know, like multiple colors. So I am going to use two colors today, one in my inner lid and one in the middle of my eyelid. Dark is this dark green shade which I would be applying right next to my outer V. For your eyelids, you use such kind of flat shader brushes or, you know, angular brushes as well. But if you use these kind of brushes, the application on the eyelid is much more like easier. You can also use your fingers, but brushes gives you more precise look. Or you can also use these kind of small brushes. Like, these are also flat shader brushes, but like a little version of these ones. You can use these ones to, you know, like blend out the edges, like which needs a very precise blending. In that case, you can use this brushes. Okay, so as you can see, I have applied the green shade in the middle of my eyelid up to my crease. Do not go, you know, above your crease. Just apply it to the place where your crease is. So once I've applied this green shade, I am going to go in with an orange shade, this one right here. So once you're applying both the shades on your eyelid, what you need to do is you need to grab a small pencil brush like this and blend the edges of the color so that they look, you know, kind of mixed up and kind of properly blended. So as you can see now, all the colors are looking, you know, properly blended and everything. So like, we are done with the eyelid and crease part. You can also add glitter or shimmers if you want to. So I am using this glittery gold liner from Hilary Rhoda, and I would be applying it not all over my eyelid but just in the middle over the green shade to give, like, you know, a little bit of a glittery effect. So as you can see, I've applied the glitter only in the middle of my eyelid, and I've just, you know, patted down with the help of my fingers. So once we are done with that, the next thing comes is our lower lash line. So for your lower lash line, you can use pencil brushes like these ones, either this one or this one. So these are known as pencil brushes. You also use these brushes to do your smoky eye, to, you know, smudge out your kajal or anything. So as I have applied orange, green and dark brown shade on my eyelid, what I'm going to do, I'm going to apply a similar kind of color in my lower lash line. So I am going to take this orange shade, you know, very little bit of this orange shade, and I would be blending it out in my lower lash line. So I'm not going really heavy with the highlighter thing because as I've told you, the eye makeup is already a lot heavier. So I'm going to apply very little bit of highlighter in my brow bone and in my tear duct. So once we are done with that, we need to apply our mascara, because mascara completes the look. Or you can also apply falsies if you want, like false eyelashes if you want to. So for the mascara, I am going to use this Maybelline Last Sensational mascara, and I would be applying it on my lower and upper lashes. I'm done applying my mascara. So as in this look, I'm not using any black kajal. I would be using a white one. So the white kajals really help your eyes to look like a lot bigger than they actually are. So I have applied the white kajal, as you can see, in my eyes. So that's it. Our eye makeup has been completed. You can finish it off with the help of false eyelashes if you want to, but I don't feel like applying falses because they feel like really heavy on the eyelashes. So I just don't like applying them. And you can also leave the look here because the eyes are looking really, really flattery and really nice. So that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you like my video. And if you do, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe. And I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye.